Daimler presents the new Freightliner Cascadia at CES in Las Vegas, and with it, the first truck in North America that offers autonomous driving level 2.
Welcome to Las Vegas. Before I go and visit the CES here in Vegas, I just received an invitation from Daimler Trucks and Buses to have a closer look at the new Freightliner Cascadia. And the important thing with that car is it now offers for the very first time autonomous driving level 2. What that means in detail, let's find out now.
Freightliner is the truck brand of Daimler in the USA and just finished another record sales year.
2018 was a very satisfying, gratifying year for us. We finished with more than 500,000 units on a record level in trucks sold. North America plays a vital and very important role in that whole picture. We had a very, very strong market in the US and Canada. And as a true market leader here in North America, we certainly benefited from that trend.
The Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas is basically a rather unusual occasion for the world premiere of a truck. But after a closer inspection, it fits.
CES and trucks match perfectly together. Why? Because trucks is all about technology and development of technology. And whilst we had in the past a lot focus on materials and mechanics, the focus in the last couple of years shifted more towards electronic. And electronic not so much into the hardware piece, but more and more into software. And that's a perfect match. It's what we have on the consumer electric side to adopt that for the commercial vehicle transportation business.
During the CES, Daimler is celebrating two premieres with the new Freightliner Cascadia in North America. Because the Cascadia is not only a new truck, it is also the first in its class to offer partial autonomous driving in the so-called Level 2.
Autonomous driving Level 2 means, of course, autonomous driving, but it also means loads of safety features. And one is right behind me demonstrated, which is emergency braking.
The Active Brake Assist 5 takes the input from both the radar and the camera. The input from the radar and the camera are fused so that we can determine if a collision is imminent. We start by warning the driver first. We issue an optic acoustic warning, after which we go into a warn braking phase, and then we go into a full emergency braking. When we go into the full emergency braking mode, we can experience deceleration as high as 7 m/s², which is quite dramatic. The braking conditions depend heavily on the road conditions, as you can imagine. What we do is we demand a certain deceleration rate, and our ABS module determines based on the load, based on the road conditions, and all other conditions that are required for the stability and safety of the vehicle so that we can achieve braking to the shortest distance.
For us car drivers, adaptive cruise control or lane keeping assistance is not really something new. But what does Level 2 actually mean in a truck?
The automation in vehicles is standardized by SAE in 5 different levels, level 1 to level 5. Level 1 is like adaptive cruise, level 5 is fully automated, and level 2 is including braking, accelerating and steering. So it is the longitudinal movement as well as the lateral movement of the vehicle. We are able to influence it. And so automation here means it's adaptive cruise for the longitudinal movement by engaging brakes, engine, transmission. And now we added the steering as well by electrified steering so that we can also keep the vehicle in the lane. First of all, you need to make it safe. So those features are nice, but they are only nice as long as they work as they are intended to. And to make it safe, you have to give it some time. And a truck, a heavy truck, is just a different animal than a car. We look at the dimensions, look at the weight. So, and if I look back, we are maybe 10 years behind, but it started with only a few high-end luxurious cars. So I believe we are actually in a good shape where we are right now with following it in for a normal car, less only a few years later. So I believe we are in a very good shape. And we, as I said, we wanted to make it safe. We have to make it safe.
For the Cascadia, there are different aerodynamic packages available, which not only provide a lower fuel consumption, but also make the truck look very modern.
When we talk about modern trucks, we of course talk about aerodynamics, and that is the same with the new Cascadia. We can see that front, we do have an aerodynamic optimized grill here for the airflow we have for the car, which is very low down to the ground. We only have a couple of centimeters between the front splitter and the tarmac. So when we look to the side of the car, we do have optimized rearview mirrors. We do have extra air panels here to make the airflow a bit easier and more efficient. And then when you look at the side of the car, it really looks a bit like a sports car. So very, very low down to the ground. everything is covered to optimize the airflow. And it's the same here with the wheels. We do not only have these covered rims, we also have extra panels between the two wheels here to really make the air easily go around the car. And that, at the end of the day, really brings a lot regarding to fuel consumption.
Semi-autonomous trucks should not only make the roads safer, they are also offering many benefits for the drivers.
It is a efficiency benefit, and first and foremost, automated or half, it's not a system like this which relieves the driver from braking, accelerating, optimizes fuel efficiency, because no driver is perfect for 8-10 hours a day, and this system always has the same alertness factor, so this helps a lot. So this is the first efficiency improvement. The second one certainly is the safety aspect. If you just imagine in heavy trucking one accident, the cost coming with one accident, it's an easy math to figure out that this is a benefit if you have those systems on board supporting the driver.
That's it from Daimler buses and trucks, and I think it's quite interesting to see that it takes a bit more time to find autonomous driving in trucks than buses, but still I have to say it's quite interesting to see what these big fellas can deliver on the road.